Hello guys, welcome back. In the last video, we had been discussing about data types in C. I mean data types and sizes of various data types in C. In this video, we will discuss something about operators in C. So first of all, let us understand what are operators. Operators means these are those which operate on operands to give some result for the operation. So we have some expression. In that expression, we will have certain operators, we will have certain operands, and that entire expression when evaluated will give us some result. So that expression is known as the operation. Okay, or actually the function that has been performed in that expression is known as the operation. So operators are of three types: unary operators, binary operators, and ternary operators. So unary operators are those which can operate on only one operand. Binary operators operate on two operands, and the ternary operator operates on three operands. So unary operator, the example of unary operators are negation is the best example for the unary operator. Other than that, we have binary operators like plus, minus, multiplication, division, modulo division, and so on. Ternary operators, there is something called this one, this ternary operator. Under this miscellaneous tab, we have this one. This is a ternary operator which is used in condition checking, and we will take a look at this operator later on when we discuss decision statements in C. So other than that, we have certain types of operators. For example, arithmetic, relational, logical, bitwise, assignment, and some other miscellaneous operators. So arithmetic operators, as the name itself suggests, these operators are used to perform some arithmetic operations. For example, plus, minus, division, multiplication, division, modular division, etc. are the arithmetic operators, and these are binary in nature. Then we have this increment and decrement operators. These are unary operators, unary in nature, so they can operate on one operand itself. Then we have the relational or the comparison based operators. So the relational operators are used to make a comparison between maybe one or more between two or more values, to check whether some value is larger than some other value, or maybe some value is equal to some other value, and so on. Then we have the logical operator. As you must have earlier studied, that there are some logic gates. So the basic logic gates that you studied are the AND, OR, and NOT. These were the three fundamental logic gates. So these logical operators also work something similar to that. This double ampersand represents an AND operator. This double pipe symbol represents an OR operator, and this exclamatory mark or exclamation mark represents a negation or a NOT operator. Then we have the bitwise operator. Bitwise operator and logical operator perform more or less the same task. The only difference is that bitwise operators operate on single bits, and logical operators operate on the entire result or the entire value. This thing will become even more clear when I discuss it through a code. So as of now, let us understand that bitwise operator are supposed to be operating on single bits, that is one bit at a time. So the single ampersand represents a bitwise AND, the single pipe represents a bitwise OR, and this exponent sign represents a XOR. And at the end, we have two more. This one is the left shift operator, and this one is the right shift operator. Okay, so even these two are the bitwise operators. Then we have the assignment operators. Assignment operators, the name itself says, or the name itself is self-explanatory, that assignment operators are used when we have to assign some value to some variable. Okay, so it can be direct equal to, it can be plus equal to, minus equal to, multiplication equal to, division equal to, and so on and so forth. So these are various assignment operators. Now, in order to get a better understanding of the operators, let us take a look at a code. Over here, I've already written this code so that we don't waste too much time in writing the code. So over here, the first section is arithmetic operators. Now I have taken two variables, say A and B. The value of A is 5 and the value of B is 8. Okay, so first of all, let us take a look at arithmetic operators or arithmetic operations. So the first operation that has been performed is addition, A plus B. There is nothing to explain in this first section. So this is addition, this is subtraction, this is multiplication, this is division. And over here we have a modular operation, modular arithmetic or modular division. So over here you must be noticing that I have written two percentage signs. This is actually percentage sign. A single percent sign acts as a format specifier in C. We shall discuss it later on in the next video. But as of now, remember that this single percentage cannot be placed in situations where you want to actually print a percentage sign in the output screen. So that's why you have to accompany it with one more percentage sign. Okay, so that was the arithmetic operators. Now we have the relational operators. In the relational operators, see, the value of A is 5, the value of B is 8. So A greater than 5, this is making a comparison. The comparison is that whether A is greater than B or not. So obviously when A is 5 and B is 8, this comparison is a false or a contradiction. So essentially the output will be 0. Because in computer logic, false is represented using a 0. And obviously a true is represented by a 1. So A less than B will be a true value. So it will show 1 as the output. A equal to B. Obviously this is also false because A and B don't have the same value. So if A equal to B will be false, then A not equal to B has to be true. Okay, A not equal to B means both of them, A and B, don't have the same value. Then we have A less than equal to B. Over here, the thing that is to be noticed is, here we had only less than sign. And here we have a less than equal to sign. That means this will match, this will actually return, this will not match, this will return a true if either the value of A is less than B or it is equal to B. Okay, so this will work in both the cases. Similarly, in this case, we have A greater than equal to B. So this will return a true value if either A is greater than B or it is equal to B. Now we have the logical operators. So over here we have only three of them. The first one is the logical AND, this is the logical OR, and this is the logical NOT. So NOT operator is a unary operator, as you can see. Logical AND means, suppose, in actually what happens in binary logic or in computer logic, any false value is represented by a zero, and any other true value or any other number in the number system represents a true value, whether the number is a negative number or the number is a positive number. So both negative and positive numbers represent a true value. So when we have A ampersand B, that means the value of A is 5, so 5 ampersand, double ampersand actually, 8. So we have 5, which is a true. We have 8, which is again true. So according to logic or Boolean algebra, when two true values are added together, they obviously give output as a true value. So that is why the output of A double ampersand B will be a 1, because both the values are 5 and 8, that is true. Next we have the OR operator. So this OR operator will produce a, obviously it will produce a 1 because both the values are true. But just in case, say value of A is maybe 6 and the value of B comes out to be 0. So in that case, although A or B will produce a, you know, some positive value or a 1, but A double ampersand B, this will represent, or this will present a negative value, or it will present a 0. Because A ampersand B, that means if one value is say 5 and the other value is say 0, so 5 and 0, according to Boolean logic, it stands out to be 0, and that is why the output of this statement will be a 0. Now over here we have not A. Not A means not true. In this case, obviously A is 5, so it is true. That's why not A means not true. That means a false. So the output will essentially be a 0. Next we have the assignment operator. See over here, this, when you write any assignment in this form, you are essentially using the C++ shorthands. So A plus equal to B is nothing but, it is equivalent to A equal to A plus B. So whether you write A plus equal to B or you write A equal to A plus B, both mean or both convey the same meaning. Okay, so this is known as, this notation is known as the C++ shorthands, or shorthands in C or C++. So this plus equal to B means A is equal to A plus B. Here we have A is equal to A minus B. Here we have A multiplied is equal, A multiplied equals to B. So this means A is equal to A into B, or A multiplied by B. Similarly, we have A is equal to A by B, and A is equal to A percentage sign B. This percentage sign is used for modular arithmetic, or it returns to us the remainder of this division that is performed. Then we have the bitwise operator. This one, the important thing that needs to be understood is that it operates on bits, that means only binary values. Suppose we have two, or rather we had taken A and B. So the value of A was 5 and B was 8. So in binary logic, we can represent 5 by writing 0, 1, 0, 1. So this is our 5, and then B will be 1000. Now if we perform a bitwise AND, that means this is our 0th bit. So AND will be performed between this and this bit. Then again this and this bit. Then we have this 3rd bit and finally the 4th bit. So that is how bitwise operators work. That means they perform logical, I mean any logical operation, they perform bit by bit. So that is why the name is given as bitwise operators. So this one is obviously a bitwise operator, that is A ampersand B. Okay, so A and B. This is A or B. This is A XOR B. What the logic of XOR is that, in case of XOR, as you must have maybe studied earlier as well, in case of XOR, if two values are the same, okay, for example, in the truth table, if you perform a XOR between 1 and 1, then the output will be a 0. Moreover, if you perform a XOR operation between 0 and 0, that means XOR between two zeros, so 0 XOR 0, that will also be a 0, because the logic of XOR is such that if the two operators are same, either this or this, if the two operators are the same, or rather if the two operands are the same, then the output will be a 0. Otherwise, if the operands are of some this kind, say 0 XOR 1 or 1 XOR 0, then the output will be a 1. So that was the logic of XOR. Now last, this is obviously negation, so it will just give us the negated value. And lastly, we have the shift operator. Shift operator means, say we had A. A was 5, so 5 in binary form is written as 0101. Now if, okay, this one represents a left shift and this one represents a right shift. So if we are to perform a left shift on A by 2, see, this is the value, or this is the variable on which left shift has to be applied. This is obviously the left shift symbol. And lastly, we have 2. That means by how many positions do we want to shift the value? So over here we have A left shift 2. That means I want to shift the value 2 positions, obviously towards the left. So what will happen is this 0 and this 1, they will get discarded. What we will have is this 0 in place of 1, this 1 in place of 0. That is for the first time. For the next time, when the second shift is performed, the 0 over here will go in this position, the 1 over here will come to the second position, and then we will have the first position and the 0th position holding zeros. Let us just run this code so that you can understand the code better. So this is obviously the dev C++ ID that I am using, just for the reason that it has an integrated compiler and an integrated environment to work on. So this simplifies my task. So first of all, over here we have the arithmetic operators whose output is quite obvious. Then we have the relational operators. So A greater than B, that means 5 greater than B or not. If not, then it will obviously print a 0. So similarly, as I already have explained, I'm not going to it again. So these are the outputs. Now let us directly come to the bitwise operators. See, A and B is equal to 0. A or B is equal to 13. I don't know as of now what is the value for A and B, okay, because some alteration has been made during this assignment and the arithmetic operations. So over here, if you notice A or B, it will give a 15. Then we have A or B, that is giving a 13. Not A is equal to minus 6. This is a left shift performed over here. So left shift of A by 2 places gives us 20. And right shift gives us 1. So let us try and understand. Suppose the value of A is 5. So what we will get is 0101. Upon performing the first left shift, we will get 1010. See, this 0 has been discarded. We do not have it anymore over here. Then this 1 takes the position of 0. This 0 takes the position of 1. And this one takes the position of this zero. So essentially it gives us a blank field right at the end. So that field is that field will be actually occupied by zero. So if you left shift 5 by 2, you can see that upon performing the first shift, we are getting this value. Upon performing the second shift, we will get 0100. So this should be the value. But again, as because there have been some alterations, maybe the output is slightly different. Then again, similarly, we have this right shift operator. In the case of left shift, the shift was carried on towards the left side. In the right shift operators, the shift will be done in the right side. So these are the various outputs that we are getting. So that is actually all about operators in C. These are very simple. Maybe this code will be shared with you, so you can always take the values and try your hands on it. You can always tweak the code and then try and understand the concept. So that is no harm at all. Thank you for this video.